Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Becky, and today we're going to be working on a 12 by 12 layout as per usual. Occasionally we might do something else, but yes, today we are going to be working on a 12 by 12 layout. I am using items that are from a stack of stuff that was shoved into a box. So I'm just picking out some of the pieces that I think I might like to use on this layout. I am going to be scrap lifting myself. You can see it in the top left hand corner of your screen. This is a layout that was in that flip through that I had done that I pulled out and put aside. I did pull out, I don't know, I think the final count was like 8 layouts to scrap lift, and this is the first one, I believe, that of what I had pulled out with you guys that I'm going to go ahead and tackle. It does turn out quite different from the first one, but you know, still, that's not the point. The point was it was like a jumping off part or jumping off piece to give me the motivation to get some layouts done. So I do love, love, love this striped paper right there. That is like one of my favorite papers. It is from close to my heart. In fact, I do believe all the papers that I use on here are going to be from close to my heart. There are just a lot of scraps that were left over, but I really love that striped paper. Now, the background paper is from the Close to My Heart Valentine's Day collection, and it has very similar colors, but they weren't even in the same collection. I went ahead and used them together, and that's fine. So this photo I'm going to be scrapbooking is of Riley and the two, or no, not Riley. Well, yes, Riley's in it. Marissa and the two babies, Riley and Riker. You can see right there. I had printed this a while ago, and I just haven't scrapbooked it yet. So I thought I'd go ahead and give it a try on here. That little piece I just had out was a smash book. I thought I could use a piece of out of there for the journaling spot, but yeah, it's not really going to work. It kind of felt a little more distressed than what I had going on my page, so I am not going to keep that there. I will end up pulling out this pack right here. It is Maggie Holmes, and I'm trying to look for a title, you know, how I've been getting into the pre-made titles lately. I did pull out that Today banner, which is cute. It also is a little bit distressed, but I do end up keeping it. And for my title, I am going to choose this word right here that says lovely. I was going to use the love, but it just, I don't know, it just wasn't that big of a statement, and that lovely I thought worked a lot better. I also did pull out this sticker sheet by Paige Evans. Right here you see I have a frame I cut in half. I'm going to put a piece on either side of the photo. That's pretty much, well, not the only thing, but that is one of the things that I did keep from the original layout. I had used a couple frames in the original layout. So yes, I did bring that over into this layout. And of course I did bring the strips up top, and then that center strip I did bring over into this layout as well. I am still playing with stickers from the Paige Evans sticker sheet. I'm going to go ahead and take the bits off. Now, in my original layout, I had used a seamstress's marking wheel through ink. I learned that by watching Janet over at RTS, and that's how I got my stitches in on the original layout. But on this one, I did just go ahead and pull out my sewing machine, and I'm just going to run a couple stitches through here. It's just white thread. Doesn't really have a huge impact on the page, but it does give you a little extra texture. I maybe might have should have pulled the thread through the front and let it hang a little bit, but I didn't do that. I just pulled it all to the back and went ahead and taped it down with a little bit of washi tape. I do need to put just a little, another piece of paper on back of that. I just have been really in this phase of having sturdy layouts, like double pages, you know, stacked up on top of each other, very sturdy. So I'm going to go ahead and put my title down. That's going to tell me where my photo is going to end up living. I'm going to commit to this piece right here, and it's the Today, but then I also found this little cloud that was on the Paige Evans sticker sheet. I do put a little foam tape underneath the left-hand side of it just to kind of balance it out with that chipboard, and I go ahead and stick it up there. That's going to serve as my little cluster up there until I go ahead and pull out the enamel dots toward the end. Here I'm going to go ahead and commit to the placement of my little cut-up frame. Now, I will switch things around. Originally, I had the flower over on the left. This, when I put it back together, I am going to put it over to the right, and I will end up putting the butterfly over to the left, whereas originally it was vice versa. Here I took a piece of that polka dotted paper that I used as a strip up at the top, and I just cut it into a banner. I'm gonna go ahead and stick it under there. That butterfly didn't fill up enough space of the inside of that frame, and not enough that I had wanted it to anyway. So I just go ahead and fill it up with that banner of that polka dotted paper. Then I go ahead and put the butterfly down on top of it. Now that butterfly is, its wings do have some foam dots under it, and this flower piece right here is also popped up on some foam dots. The fray sticker said dreams do come true, and that is going to need, the bottom part of it is going to need to be put up on foam tape, which is what I just did. Because I'm having it overlap the flowers that are already up on foam tape as well. I do take two heart stickers that are also from that Paige Evans sticker pack, and I stick those down. Now, I do have a pack of enamel dots here. I had picked these up at Hobby Lobby. They were on clearance, gosh, months ago. And it's funny because I think I mentioned this a few videos back, but I found a bag of stuff that I had purchased from Hobby Lobby, and I was like, huh. Who knew? Apparently, I brought it home with the bag and just kind of threw it over to the side and forgot about it. So yes, these enamel dots were some of them. I do like the enamel dots, but the problem for me with the enamel dots from Hobby Lobby, their brand, the Paper Studio brand, they don't have small enough ones. They have plenty of very large enamel dots on the page, but not very many small. It's like they have large and medium, but they don't have small ones. So I'm not a super huge fan of the enamel dots from there, but they were on clearance, so yay. Even if I only use the medium size, it's perfectly fine. All right, guys, I want to thank you so much for joining me. Please check the links down below, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.